Hello, this is One Life for Fights. On May 23rd, Brazil's Klidson de Abreu will return to take on UFC sophomore Jamahal Hill, part of the UFC's fourth out of four events scheduled to take place in 15 days. This information is yet to be confirmed officially by the promotion, as it was received from an unanimous source with knowledge of the booking. The event's location is still to be announced. The conflict between Israel Adesanya and Tyron Woodley grows with every comment one throws against the other. Woodley discussed previously his plans of clearing out the welterweight division and eventually moving up to face UFC middleweight champion Adesanya. But during that discussion, he made sure to throw some jabs at the champion, claiming that Adesanya is scared of guys with power, referring to his fight with Yoel Romero. Adesanya, on the other hand, fired back, taking aim at Woodley's performance against Kamaru Usman, in which he lost the welterweight title. Speaking during the Hollywood Beatdown segment on TMZ, Woodley claimed that Adesanya has taken his call out way too personally, as the beef continues to brew. He claimed that both Adesanya as well as Robbie Lawler are much too sensitive. Before UFC 249, the middleweight Ronaldo Souza claims he has an ace in his hand thanks to having to stay at home lately. Jacare's wife regularly trains CrossFit, and Souza has been forced to adapt his training to take advantage of his wife's at-home training equipment, as he gets himself sharp ahead of his fight with Uriah Hall on May 9th. He claimed that his first training with his wife made him sore, her being very strong and helping him a lot with the training. Dropping back to his natural weight class at UFC 249, Souza will face the enigmatic Hall, whose striking skills can produce spectacular results inside the octagon. Jacare knows all about Hall's abilities but says he will find a way to overcome them and get his hand raised once again. If he succeeds in that mission, Souza says he wants to avenge one of his two recent losses to either Yoel Romero or Kelvin Gastelum. He also said that he doesn't plan to spend a full week at Jacksonville. Instead, he will have a few hours drive just a few days ahead the contest. Due to the ongoing coronavirus pandemic, the UFC has made significant cutbacks on the number of people allowed in the arena on fight night. However, one population not affected by the cutbacks on May 9th, May 13th and May 16th will be the fighters' corner man. Multiple people with knowledge of the situation confirmed that fighters will be allowed the usual limit of 3 corner men for their upcoming fights in Jacksonville, Florida. In an online meeting held with fighters on April 17th, UFC President Dana White said the number of people that will be allowed at the event was still fluid. He indicated that UFC would likely have to limit the amount of people on scene, so White said fighters will likely have to make tough decisions pertaining to who they allow to corner them. It's not uncommon for some fighters to be accompanied by more than 3 team members on fight weeks. Additional fight week personnel can include nutritionists, massage therapists, managers, and others. With the UFC's hotel policy, only UFC staff, their selected corners, and fighters are permitted on the premises. While UFC president Dana White was not willing to reveal specifics, Friday he told ESPN a different interesting matchup. Not Usman is on the table for the BMF champion. Prior to the coronavirus pandemic to the postponement of the upcoming UFC schedule, all signs pointed to Usman vs. Masvidal as a potential matchup for UFC 252 on July 11. The event was supposed to coincide with the annual International Fight Week, which White has since said it will likely be cancelled. White said that they are talking about a few different things for Jorge Masvidal now, saying that they have something else interesting for him, but the details are still to be found out. Thank you for watching One Life for Fights. If you liked our video, please like, comment, and subscribe.